Good morning. I am sitting here at my dining table doing some work on my laptop and thought I need to get a video up on my creator channel because I haven't done one in a while. Just a quick update. I have been traveling a ton, and when I got back, I knew I had to dive into my own socials and OnlyFans channel. So it's been a hot minute since I've been on here. So sorry. I did check. I am still in the top 1%, even with all my traveling. I do not use an agency or even a team. I did have a lovely person that was helping me for a bit. An admin. What do you call them? A virtual admin. Just helping me with some posting. And I loved it, loved it, loved it. I just did not find that I, needed it for a short period of time, and then I was able to do it myself again. But it would definitely be something I would advise using if you can, or if you need that to assist you for a bit, a virtual admin. I just I'm not a big fan of having an agency or another person in your stuff. I would love to have someone help me with marketing if I could find the right match. I never have been in marketing. I myself was always in, before OnlyFans, I was always in finance for years and years and years. Never had any type of marketing, work and background. So that all is new to me and I'm learning a lot, but it is, very time consuming doing all the marketing side of marketing yourself. So, but it's fun. Learning new things is a lot of fun. So that is what I spend a lot of my time doing. I think people underestimate how much marketing you have to do along with this. Because I know people think that you are sitting there in your OnlyFans page all the time, which I know you need to be, and you need to be engaged and chatting and those people have to realize that you never they never would have got there if they haven't found you on the other, on other places. So they're finding you from the socials, from Instagram, from TikTok, YouTube, wherever they're finding you from. Reddit. I'm not real big on Reddit. I have a Reddit page, but I don't post that much out there. But whatever the social is that they initially found you on, that is how they got to your page. And if you aren't on there actively, because it's like they see you for a second and then they move, then it moves on. It's constantly moving. I think the only one, and then why I like it so much, is that YouTube, this one, is not as like you're done after a 24-hour cycle. It seems like people keep finding your stuff. I see comments on my videos way after they've been posted, long after they've been posted, people still find them. And I love that part about YouTube versus say like TikTok and Instagram. It seems to me like once my video is up, it's kind of like, or once my reel or my TikTok is up, I don't see as much movement on them, after a very short cycle, I'll say. So I think that's why I am starting a lot more channels on this platform versus putting as much energy into the other ones. The other ones, granted, I still have several Instagrams and several TikToks. I just don't put as much time and effort into those. Okay, so that is my little update on my socials. Definitely have a new some new channels going up for here. My transparent channel, I do still have. I just posted my very first video that I've done in a very long time since that all went down with those transparency channels. It is a costume channel. Good timing since we're going into that season, into the Halloween season. I'm gonna do costume try-ons, which should work out great because I think the strike stays on a channel. I have one strike. Hopefully hopefully I will not get any more. It stays on, I think it said, for 2 months. So right at the end of the spooky season, hopefully it will fall off and I'll see what I want to do after that. I don't know if by then I can go back to kind of how it was set up before, or if I'll need to pivot and do something different with that channel. We'll see. But I do not want to lose that channel with 135,000 subscribers. So I'm going to do whatever will not make me lose that channel, even if I have to follow the community guidelines. Exactly. I have a bikini try-on channel. I have a new one that's called Amy's Daily Adventures. And that one is like more of what I do daily. I don't think people realize, like, I have a wood yard in my backyard. I have a splitter. I heat my home with a wood stove. So I'm going to have some of those. Niching down really well seems to work on a lot of the platforms. And guys like to see, it seems like, women or girls doing things that men usually do. So I'm going to be doing some of the wood stacking and wood splitting and showing some of that on my videos. And then other things I do daily, the cleaning ASMR is really big, which obviously I clean, so we'll do some of that filming, and that will be on my daily adventures, as well as when I travel, and just some more of my daily stuff. That's going to be on that channel. I also, as far as your OnlyFans, I definitely, since we're going into September, would advise you to check out the finance side of what you've been doing. My video stopped, so I think it stopped right when I was saying check into your finance side. If you already have a tax advisor, perfect. You're a step ahead of me. Next year, I might go ahead and do that. I set aside a certain amount every each time I pull it out, I have a separate savings. I think I talked about this in one of my other videos. If you haven't set up separate accounts for your business, it doesn't have to necessarily be a business account. That's totally your call. But I set up a separate account right away, separate checking and savings. I did the checking, and all of my funds that I get from OnlyFans or whatever platform you're using, not everyone uses OnlyFans, I have a couple different streams of income. So I get paid from OnlyFans, I get paid from TikTok, I get paid from YouTube, I'm monetized on my YouTube channel. So I have other forms too. So I have a few different forms of income. All of that goes directly into my checking account, but I pull out a certain amount every time I get, and then I transfer that to the savings, because I don't want to have it at the end of the year where I owe all of this money for taxes. So definitely set that up and set aside your money for taxes. And so what I just did recently is, since we're going into September, I didn't want to be like surprised and be like, oh my gosh, am I okay? I took how much I have made through the different places and just made sure I was on track. And I, you know, it seems that I am. So hopefully I'm not going to hit any big penalties for not doing quarterly taxes this year. This is my first full year doing this full time as self-employed. Last year it was only half of a year, and I didn't have any big penalties, but this year, you know, next year I might have to, next year I'm thinking I'm going to do quarterly taxes. So I did do that checkup, and I would recommend you do the same thing and make sure you have like a separate savings where you're putting the money into. Plus you'll get better interest if you have a good chunk of money that you're putting into the savings. All right, I think that's about it for updates. I'm also doing lives on TikTok, back into that world a little bit, only because I will be doing heavy lives during NFL season. I get usually quite a bit of fans that convert over when I do lives during NFL seasons on TikTok, or I did last year anyway. So I'm hoping I have the same conversion this year. TikTok's pretty hard on me though, unfortunately, now. So we'll see, as far as like they take my content down a lot and my lives down a lot. But I'm hoping that I'm very, very conservative. it'll go better this year. Anyway, I hope you have a great day. I hope you enjoy this. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments and I will answer them. And if you like this, please like, subscribe, and follow, share, and you have a great day. Bye, guys.